Hi, my name is Ezanna Kassahun, and I'm part of MMRT, our Multimedia Resource and Training Institute. And yesterday we had the pleasure of listening into Ambassador Kassa, where there was a meeting with many people, and we were able to listen on the conversation they had about Ethiopia. And the majority of the talk was connecting Ethiopian diaspora here in America with the Ethiopians there and how to bridge the gap between them. And we were able to listen on to a really lengthy, really good conversation. And today we were able to come here and have an interview with Ambassador Kassa. She'll tell you a little bit about it.
Yeah, it's okay. And my name is Banchi, and I'm also a member of MMRTI. And I had a pleasure or an honor of talking to Ambassador Kassa, and I asked him multiple questions about youth involvement with Ethiopia's development, basically. And he gave us really good answers and hope for the future. And he said there will be in the future, they're working on involving the youth, diaspora youth, and creating multiple programs and encouraging us basically to connect with the youth back home. And and he promised to help us with whatever we need with as much resources as possible.
The experience was really great to learn about our culture and about the different, how politicians are trying to help hear the youth, and they're willing to hear and improve the different things that they can improve on, because it just shows that our opinions matter. And also when we were listening onto the conversations, they're really trying to develop the country and see the different ways that they could bring change. And I think it's really nice that to see that they're listening into us and they're actually caring about our opinions.
Okay, so one thing that I really liked that he kept talking about in many different topics is that the idea of organizing, being organized, and specifically for the youth, if we get organized as a group, as one, we can make a lot of differences going back home and contributing to the current development that Ethiopia is going or having. What do you think?
Yeah, I also think the same thing, and being responsible for yourself and coming together to unite so you guys could push yourself higher and higher, because taking credibility and responsibility will bring a lot of change, especially when he was talking about how for like the past couple of years we've been taking students and young adults to Ethiopia, and how he'll provide support, but the change will come once you go there, and they'll continue to support you once you establish yourself and bring credibility and going back and forth. So I think that's really a good thing.
I really believe that as a youth here in America, what we can do to make a change or to make a difference in Ethiopia is that we can learn more things that as much as we can, because we have an opportunity to do so, and use that opportunity. And through the embassy, like Ambassador Kassi said, they will have a lot more support for us. Use that opportunity, use our knowledge and skills, and help the youth back home to have those skills as well.
Like she was saying, using our opportunity that we have here to bridge the gap by we already have established some router, like the bridges, and with their help we could make a connection so we could give them the technology that they need to develop their country and improve their way of life, because I feel like that doing even the simplest things could go a far way, because it'll just go on top of each other, and I think that's a really good thing. So in the next few weeks, we'll be showing you guys the different videos and photos that we have of back in Ethiopia and what we've recorded right now in the last couple days. And thank you for listening from Ezanna and Banchiamlak.